So, Tara, congratulations on 2x2 Overboard.
Thank you.
It's been 5 years now since the last adventure. What's it been like now coming back to Hazel and the kind of the whole family on the arc?
Oh, it's been fantastic. It was lovely when we heard there was going to be a second one, because the first one had done really, really well and was an Irish box office hit. And then it went around the world, different voices and things in different places around the world. But it did really well. So we got a second movie, which is unreal. It's fantastic to have a sequel. And I think I loved the first one, but I think the sequel's even better. There's a lot of action and it's great crack.
And what is it that you kind of like about this? Because I actually quite find the animation itself is quite adorable and the characters are very interesting, especially, I think, yourself and Leah. I like the style of kind of lupine, kind of bronze lupine that you have.
What do you love? You calling me a wolf? Hazel is a Grymp. The character's called a Grymp because the thing is... it is the arc story, that's the jumping off point, but it's not like the biblical story as such. There are lots of new characters. We don't see Noah, that's not a spoiler. It's all about the animals and it's all about their adventures on the arc. Like what happens when you put predators, you know, herbivores and carnivores together? What could possibly go wrong? So Grymps, Hazel's a Grymp, that's my character. And Hazel is, you know, she's great. It was great to get the claws out. It's always good to kind of get the claws into something and teeth, sharp teeth into the role. So, and lots of growling. I really got to go down into those depths of my own character and find the inner growl. So that was fun to do.
Sorry, there's a furry friend behind you.
That cat, every time the camera switched on, if I'm doing a Zoom with the camera off, the cat doesn't appear.
Okay.
There she is. There's
yes, lovely.
Anyway, thanks very much. Yeah, she's trying to get it. She's trying to blend in with the characters in the
poster. It works. It works, actually. It's great promotion. And, well, you know, have you actually gotten to meet Ava over the years?
No, I haven't. I know Dermot McGuinness, who plays Dave, the Nestrian. Mm-hmm. Other than that, we don't get to meet in studio. That's the thing. Animation is mainly recorded separately. Yeah. Parts recorded separately. So it is a bit of an out-of-body experience. You're doing all these action-packed adventures and chases and escapes and all these exciting things that happen in the film. And you're kind of, you're doing it in a studio by yourself. But it is so lovely then, the treat of that is then seeing it assembled when it all gets put together and you do see this gorgeous, and it is gorgeous. It's an Irish-led animation team, many countries co-production, but it's just beautiful. Feel so proud to see it because it is so visually stunning. That's why I'm really glad it's coming out in cinemas. Yep. So it was worth the wait during level 5, I think, because cinemas have worked really hard. The whole industry has worked really hard to make cinemas safe to reopen, I think on the 4th of December.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, so it'll be in then, and it is really worth seeing on the big screen. But you can see the first one on Netflix if you want to watch something at home before you go.
Lovely, and also to get the story and the backstory of these characters.
Yes, exactly, because it isn't exactly the Bible story, so you will need a little bit of background.
Yes, and you know, you spoke there on Irish cinemas. People might have seen you, or at least heard you recently in the entertainment.ie video for Irish cinemas.
Yeah.
What was that like to record?
Oh, it was lovely. Well, that was a very casual kind of recording setup because as so many things, we're all doing things at home. There's a lot of at-home recording happening at the moment.
Yeah.
Which means you don't even get to see the engineer or the producer or anything like that, which is, it is a loss. It is. It's so much of what we all do in this industry is collaboration, and it feels kind of weird to be separate. But that was just a lovely thing to have a sit down and think about what cinema meant to be to me and cinema experiences. So in my bit, I speak about seeing Goodfellas in the Savoy and the idea of that queue around the block. Now, during these COVID-y times, it seems like a million years ago, but it's such a strong memory for me. At that time, I used to go to the movies every weekend. I used to go, I would start at the early afternoon showings and go right through to the night. I used to just see everything. Imagine having that kind of time now, says everybody. Able to be out.
Yeah.
But it was something, that was my hobby. That was my one big spend in the week. And that was my hobby. And I absolutely love cinema. So it's just gorgeous to have something coming out at a time when there isn't a ton of stuff.
Yeah. And, you know, you're no stranger to family entertainment and that and adventure. You were Molly for the Morbegs.
Yes, I was. I was one of the Mollies. They were not to ruin anyone's illusions, but there were a couple of teams on Morbegs because the work was so hard.
Yeah.
The people in the suits really needed to take breaks.
Yeah.
They were quite hot and quite heavy, but not in a bad way, just in a physical way.
Yes.
So, but it was a great show to work on. You talk about collaboration. That's the kind of thing I wonder about how they will make now. But it really was a kind of a circus family coming together, working really hard, long hours, really intense. And then, you know, just hanging out after together, everyone, lifelong friends made on that show. It was just, it's just a fantastic thing. And it's lovely to do work for kids because all we all do is storytelling.
Yeah.
And kids will be, they won't be long telling you when something isn't to their taste. And often it would happen on the sets, like in the second and third years of Morbegs, when kids would come on set, kind of like, no, Molly, that's wrong. And you're like, okay.
And you had to put up with it. God, chill.
Oh, no, they were fabulous. It's brilliant. It's brilliant when you see that magic and your storytelling. But when it's kids stuff, you're hoping to make it magic. And there is a great bit of magic in this. Seeing it all come together, it feels like magic, even when you've seen the nuts and bolts of putting the jigsaw together.
Yeah.
So it's very exciting, and I really hope people enjoy it. It's great for little smallies. It's really into them, but everyone else can appreciate the crack and the visuals, and I think everyone will have a good time.
I'm surprised when I was watching it. I'm surprised it does go to not completely dark, but there are moments of kind of, I would say, shock, a bit of terror towards the end. Were you surprised? Because the first one, it's not as dark. I don't want to say dark as is to put as if
an adventure. Like, a shadow. This one's an adventure, and there's a bit of a race against time. Mm. So that's why the ante is up here. But it's not. Mm. I don't think it's super scary. There's nothing sort of really nightmare inducing.
No.
It's but everyone loves a bit of a scare, a manageable scare. Like every fairy tale has that.
Yeah.
But this is just an adventure for our characters to go on that they will try and get through together. And so the real focus of it is getting together to get out of a scrape. So I think that's, you know, they're already in a high pressured situation, like with the rest of us during lockdown, being on top of other people, if we live with other people for a long time, supply is running out. So, it creates tensions, but it is really suitable for smallies. There is some excitement towards the end.
Yeah.
But our heroes are well up for it, never fear.
And there's a wonderful theme of acceptance and helping out, which is something also very timely as well.
Yeah, I think so.
That, yeah. You have to look on the better side of things.
Yeah, and their own shortcomings. Like Hazel, my character, she gets very grumpy, and it doesn't always work out well. She's kind of a growly, grumpy, impetuous carnivore, and she, you know, the impetuousness doesn't always get her in a good place. So she's great at taking action, but is it always the right action? So she has a lot to learn, and everyone learns from each other. And it's not super sort of overly sentimental, but there's a lot of friendship as a theme, and also lots and lots of people who are very, very different, all coexisting together, which no harm for us all to have a look at.
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, you were saying there you don't get to see much of the other cast, but would you have gotten to see Toby and Sean?
Directors? Toby and Moe. So Moe
Honan, Moetion
Films in Galway. Yeah, huge, huge part of this story. So Toby and Moe were the ones we were working with directly.
Mm. And did you get to, what was Toby and that like as directors and leading you through your adventure as Hazel?
They're fantastic. I mean, the worst thing about them, the only gripe I have with them is when they come in and start taking pictures of you in the booth when you're going, and you're like, please not now, guys. Why not when I'm doing a lovely serene scene? But of course, that's no crack. So that's my only gripe with them, and I will have my revenge.
And you know, you were saying cinemas are opening up, and we're all very happy about that kind of escapism. Are you excited to bring, you know, your own family, your own friends, and that to see this to show off?
I can't wait for them to see. Well, it's sort of like you kind of feel like with something like animation, and especially at the moment when the release was delayed, you feel like they don't believe you that it happened. Like, you went into a dark room and you came out and like, oh, really? An animation feature? Yeah, really? Oh, sure.
Yeah.
See, it's here. So yeah, that's very exciting. And it's just, it's not even about showing off. It's pride. Yeah. It's when you look at the credits on an animation film and you see all the people involved and you're one tiny piece of that, it's just, it makes you burst with pride that all these people, I guess it's like, you know, the metaphor in the film, but all these people coming together to make something and make it work. Does that sound too schmaltzy? Well, it's nearly Christmas. No, I'm doing it.
Because that's kind of the film. The film is very sweet and, you know, there's just a wonderful message and it builds throughout the entirety of the film, I thought. Was there a particular character, if you had to choose, apart from Hazel, obviously, a particular character, maybe new or old, your favourite? I thought Patch was quite funny.
Patch is great.
Yeah.
I think Jelly is going to really appeal to
Little. Yes, yes, sorry. Oh, God.
Jelly, I forgot. Where is she? She's there. There's Jelly. I think Jelly is going to be a big hit.
Yeah.
Jelly just has to open her wibbly wobbly mouth and I'm in bits. I'm just like, oh, Jelly, you're so cute. But she's,
there's no filter.
Not just cute, she's a big help in the film. So I can't wait for people to see that.
And finally, you know, we're, this is kind of just a thing I was wondering, would you hope to have a third adventure with Hazel and the gang?
God, yes, I would do 10. I love this character. It's such a gorgeous team. It's such a sweet message and a message I think we need right now. And just some crack, some light relief. So to look at bright colors on a big screen, something we can do together in our bubbles. And the industry has worked really hard to make things safe, to reopen cinemas. So I would just hope that it's something families can do together, make a little memory and be proud that something has been co-produced here.
Yeah. Oh, perfect. Thank you so much, Hazel. It has been an absolute pleasure.
Okay, I'm Tara, but I'm happy to be Hazel too.
Oh, God.
No, I am Hazel.
Oh, my God.
Wow. Now out comes Toby with his camera and you just get...
Yeah.
Listen, thank you so much.
No, thank you, Tara. And like when I was...